Hello everyone, this is Karan here. You are welcome to Tech Karan YouTube channel, and today in this video I'm going to show you the review of AOSiP custom ROM based on Android 10 for Redmi Note 8. The ROM is based on Android version 10 and it has a security patch of 5th of February 2020. Yes, the latest ever security patch for this device. Now, how to install this ROM? What are the features in this ROM? Can you use this ROM as your daily driver? Is Google camera working? What are the extra things you get in this custom ROM? Everything in this video, so make sure you watch this video till the end. And now let's get straight to the video. Okay, so here as always, first of all let us take a look on the launcher, and there is some difference. You do not get the launcher, you do not get the Pixel launcher, you do not get the Google Apps pre-installed. You have to install Google Apps on your own, and also you have to install firmware first. There is a complex process I will show you at the end. As you get the quick step launcher by swiping right, you do not get anything, but by swiping down you get the notification panel here. The gesture is working perfectly. You can edit the quick settings from here, you can edit from here also. Wait, let me show you. Just click here, you can edit the columns, landscape, show labels and reset. These are the things you get in this quick setting styles. And you do not get any extra apps. You only get few of, I think approximately 8 to 9 apps, none more than that. And you get the FM radio inbuilt, you get this normal stock camera, Snapdragon camera, and Google camera is not working in my case. It is force stopping, I don't know why. So means Google camera, you can see camera keeps stopping. Google camera 7.0 is not working. You can try the latest Google camera 7.3 or Google camera, modded Google camera 5.1, which I have uploaded already on my website. You can try both of them, and if it works for you, you can comment below and tell me. And now let's move on straight to the settings as always. And in settings, as expected, we are using Android 10 based custom ROM. VoLTE and Wi-Fi calling both are working perfectly, no issues at all. You can enable from the settings. And now let's move on straight to battery. I've just installed this ROM, so I cannot share about the battery backup. You can install this ROM to get battery backup properly. See, I don't know exactly. In display section, you have the option of adaptive brightness, dark theme, screen timeout, and other normal features. You do not get the extra features in display section. Okay, so in sound panel you have the option vibrate for calls and other sounds and vibration options, which are approximately available in almost all custom ROMs, so no extra features are there also. Now let's move on back to privacy. This is the permission manager. Show password, lock screen, autofill service from Google is available, which is working, no issues at all. And now let's move on to languages and input. You get the Google keyboard, not Google keyboard by default. You have to flash Google apps, so it's better to use OpenG apps from opengapps.org official website. And developer options, you can enable these settings, you can try on your own. I will not show you which settings you have to enable. And this is the AOSiP 10 updater, which is not working. You can see the update check failed always again and again. It will show you the update check failed. Please check your internet connection, etc. So it is also not working. No OTA is working. You even cannot last check, change the last check, so it is not checking. So there is a, you cannot say bug it is, but you can say it's a bug also. Now let's move on to Owl's Nest, their own menu where you get all the customization options. In status bar you have the option of status system icons, which you can enable or disable. You have the option of NFC also, which is not working in Redmi Note 8, this Indian version. And if you are using a global version, then it will be working for you. And there is a option of display VoLTE icon, and you can see the VoLTE is properly working, no issues at all. And now let's go back. You have the option of select VoLTE icon, whichever icon you need. You can choose the icon, like if you want ASUS icon, you can change this to ASUS icon, wallet or HD. You can choose any icon, whichever you like. I like this VoLTE icon, sorry, I like VoLTE OxygenOS icon, which looks nice, so I will choose this. Battery styles are available, everything is available. Now let's move on to quick settings. Battery percentage, brightness slider, vibrate on touch only. And now let's move on. There are not a lot of customization options are available, but sometimes we have to survive without customization options. Hardware button, there is the option of screen off animation, which is a CRT or scale. If you use scale, you can see the screen off animation looks nice, and CRT, it looks like CRT television. Also, you can notice there is, it is, fingerprint option is working, and yes, my device is encrypted now. That's why fingerprint is working. And if your device is decrypted, you will not get the fingerprint option. You have to make sure about that, but you have to encrypt your device. Thanks to my one commentator, I don't know exactly the name, but yes, he said right, if your device is decrypted, you will not get the fingerprint option in that custom ROM. Now let's move on back to other things. And in navigation, you have the option of invert layout. Like, I have inverted my layout. Like, now hardware buttons, I already shown you. In lock screen, you have the option lock screen with shortcuts, battery info, visualizer, where you can use visualizer, ambient visualizer. These are the things you get. You do not get the edge lighting option, etc. Let's go back. In gesture, you have the option of jump to camera, activate the torch, system navigation, prevent ringing, and skip music tracks. These are the gestures you get in this custom ROM, which you can customize according to your own preference. And at last, you have the option of themes. You can customize the theme, you can even create your own custom theme, you can change the clock style. There are many clock styles available, bubble, analog type, Samsung default, etc. You can any choose any customized. And this was from all the settings. Now, how to install this custom ROM? Wait, let me show you. There is some different process. I've already made a video on this process, that how you can install the Android 10 based custom ROM, and you can watch that video for a proper detailed guide. This guide applies to this, the ROM installation guide applies to that video. So first, simply open the recovery, and here that I already told you my data is encrypted, so I have to decrypt this every time whenever I boot into recovery. And then here, after successfully decryption, just go to wipe, advanced wipe, Dalvik catch system vendor data. After all these things, just go back, go to install, and then install the custom ROM. Sorry, first of all, you have to install firmware of 9.12.26. the link is in description, go and check it out. Then just swipe to confirm flash, then go back. And then you have to install the custom ROM AOSiP 10 Quich Ginkgo. After installing this ROM, just install OpenG apps, install these, and then at last, what you have to do is go to wipe, go to format data, then you have to type YES and then click on OK, and then you have to boot, and that's it, your phone will be booted. And this was all from today's video. I hope you like it. Thanks for watching. Goodbye, see you in the next video.